in here. Let's hide in here.
Nina!
We are hiding out. We're totally hiding out.
We have to go back to school now. We have to go back. We're going to get in trouble.
We'll go back to school.
No, you have to. We can't stay here. What is this place?
It's an advertising studio.
We're lost now.
No, we're going to hide out here.
We're going to get taken by the cops.
No, we're not. Look over here.
Look, I hear someone. Nina, there's a security
guard. I don't care about the security guards. Let's hide.
Oh, hi, Internet.
Oh, hi.
We just got back from Kit Kettridge, American Girl.
The first major motion picture based on the American Girl stories. How do you turn the worst of times?
Everyone's in trouble these days.
Into the best.
And we're inspired. We're making dolls just like her to teach girls about American history.
Yeah, like how being a girl and buying lots of outfits is fun and awesome.
Like Samantha, the girl who teaches us about the liberating lives that girls led during the Victorian era.
Or Addie, the token black doll who teaches us with a little pluck and a happy smile, even slavery can be wished away.
Mm-hmm. Or if history is boring, instead you can buy a Just Like You doll.
They're so squeaky clean.
You know, I actually always wanted one. I did. But they were too expensive.
Yeah, what with a doll starting at $90?
Yeah, Mom would rather save for college.
What I don't get is how all those expensive accessories make sense for Kit. I mean, she was growing up in the Depression. Her overalls are hand-me-downs, but they'll cost you $30.
She made her scooter herself out of orange crates, but you can buy it for $24.
Yeah, collect them all.
So we thought it was better to make our own dolls.
Mm-hmm, yeah, the American Girl stories have ignored the lives of a lot of girls.
Who's your doll, Nina?
This is Teresa. Teresa was a little Navajo girl living in New Mexico around 1880.
Oh, she's really pretty.
Thank you. But the U.S. government had a higher calling for Teresa. She was going to get civilized! Teresa was taken to a boarding school with the other children from her tribe one night.
I'll bet that was a surprise.
The motto at the school was, "Kill the Indian and save the man," to make the Navajo and other tribes speak English and live like white people.
Teresa's hair is lovingly hand-butchered, just the way the school matron would have done in an attempt to shame her. Her orange dress was all the rage.
Well, it sure caused her a lot of rage. She had to wear this ugly thing in case she tried to escape again to get home to her parents. It had good visibility, you know, like convict's uniform.
Well, I guess there's a lot of opportunities for courageous stories with this American girl.
Okay, Erna, now tell me about your doll.
Oh, this is Chris.
But Erna, Chris is a boy.
Chris may have been born into a boy's body, but inside she is 100% American girl. She borrows her mom's gown and her sister's pantyhose, and those are sold separately, by the way, with her diary and her copy of the book. She's Not There, A Life in Two Genders.
What's with this little brochure?
Her parents are evangelical. That's from the camp they tried to send her to straighten her out.
So her parents aren't too happy about this.
That's why a little girl would want to hug Chris and give her the love and support that she needs.
For her first pair of high heels and money for the operation.
We've got other dolls planned too. A whole line of accessories for girls who are good in math and who want to be engineers. And dolls who were taken to Japanese internment camps during World War II.
We figure the American Girl Company is ready to present a more complete picture of what it means to be American and a girl.
So, internets, we want to see what dolls you want American Girl to make.
What chapters of American history do you think are being forgotten?
Make us a video and let us know.
We still haven't heard back from the company. Maybe we should email them again.
I think they'll probably come to us. All we need to do is sit back and wait.